Hi, live health. It doesn't look that great. Okay, well, we'll go. Let's see how we're going here. We're on. Hello.
We're on.
Alan, how are you, sir?
I'm good.
Michael Reyes on. Michael, I just got your message, and I'll tell you what happened.
No.
Yeah. No way are you getting that prize. What happened is we were about to go live, and at about 2 minutes to 3, the door springs open with some. A young person called John.
John. Sir John. Of Dallymore.
Dallymore fame. came in and said, you know, what do you do?
Oh, Merry Christmas, Michael. Thank you for that.
Merry Christmas, Michael Ray. And Alan, how's it going? Welcome back.
Thanks. I'm almost here.
You're almost. You were doing something last night.
Yeah, leaving due.
What happened?
Wasted.
You can tell me. I won't tell anyone.
I just can't remember.
No one's watching.
I can't remember. There he is. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Jimmy. Was he involved?
Ask him what day it is.
What day is it, Jimmy?
What day is it, Jimmy?
What day should it have been?
Yeah.
We should be on the television.
I'll tell you that story later on.
All right.
When I've got a bit fueled up.
Oh, yeah. Well, we should get right into it. What have you gone and got?
All right. Which one do you fancy first? The refreshing one? Or?
Maybe. No, I got that big mouth looking wacky do thing. Yeah.
That one.
Yeah.
This is the BentSpoke.
The BentSpoke.
Crankshaft.
Oh, goodness.
Ooh, a cranking dear. IPA.
That sounds a bit naughty.
Yeah.
Sounds a little naughty. G'day, Ian Anderson.
Seriously, I mean.
Jared Orman is on as well.
How are you supposed to read that?
Silver
writing.
Silver on
silver. Background.
Is it like one of those, remember when you got lemon and you rub the lemon or something on the paper and then the secret text came out?
No, my goodness.
I honestly can't read that. Nothing worthwhile. Okay, that's a fair comment.
Comes easily.
Oh, sorry. Taking the familiar road can rob life of its flavor. So at BentSpoke. Okay, guys. So that's just
enough.
Okay, enough. Let's
see the bowl thing. It's different.
Yeah, that's huge. Okay, well, let's see.
Let's go.
Okay, you ready? 1, 2. Holy moly!
God,
that almost blew my fingers off.
Oh, is it one of those?
Oh wow!
Oh, right. Okay.
Look at that.
Oh, that's a bit posh.
That's obscene.
That really is a bit posh.
That's obscene beer drinking. Oh, right. Well, cheers, man.
Cheers.
Welcome to the last show for the year. Oh, you want to take a huge sip out of that.
Oh.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, I like that.
I like that.
Yeah, I like
that. Now look, once you open it, you can't dip it up and see where it's from.
Like
is it from Canberra? Beer brewed and canned in Canberra.
Right. I do like the top on that.
There you go.
It's good. Cheers.
Cheers, man.
Cheers again.
Canberra's a weird place. Have you been up there?
Cheers. One for promo.
Cheers. You ready? Hang on. We'll do it again.
One of these days, we're going to drop these.
One, two, three.
Cheers.
There we go. Promo.
There you go.
Thanks, buddy. Canberra's a weird place. They have a suburb dedicated to porn. Now, that's not the weird thing. I'm quite happy with that, but...
How do you know this?
I've been there.
You used to work there.
When you get to the Canberra airport, they say, here's your raincoat, and we'll see you. It's called Fishwick. It's Fishwick.
Mm. Is this why you have a shop in South Melbourne? Are you drawn to these particular areas?
Well, what are you saying? Is South Melbourne a salubrious area? I'll tell you a story.
It can be.
Jimmy, I want to see you two drink some emu export lager.
Oh, God.
That's the sort of... Has he worked in the mines before? Mm. That's the sort of stuff a miner says.
No.
And then he murders you in the outback and puts you in a Hilux ute and buries you. But
So what are we doing today, then?
Oh, we're doing... we have a SANTANA special. SANTANA. Do you get it? SANTANA!
That was his joke, I have to say. That's all I knew, that one.
I was about to tell you a joke, I've completely forgotten. Thanks for joining us, folks. It is our last show of the year.
Yep, it's cat's piss.
It's cat's piss, oh my God.
Yeah, well, if you had been on the show,
you could have come on. We would have got you one.
Yeah, we could have anyway, next
got
time.
A funnel and force it down to him. Alan, let's have a look. What are you on? We've gone Santana to celebrate Christmas, and I'm going to do a little camera swapping activity. And you're plugged into a fancy app that I don't think we've ever used it on the show.
I've not seen one of these before, so. But it's
let's have a look. So it's a Summertone.
Overdrive 35.
Wow. Look at that.
And as you can see, I've got, I mean, it's all on master volume anyway, but I've got everything dimed on it.
Dimed.
To the max. Dime, yeah.
And what's in your grubby little hand, sir?
This, it's funny we should say about John Dalymore.
John Dalymore, yes.
But this is John Dalymore's guitar. And I did try and get him to stay,
yes,
to actually play it himself, but
yes,
but it's a lovely PRS DC3,
right?
And lovely. I think he's changed the pickups in it, hasn't he?
Yes,
these are noiseless.
He's put noiseless
and
pickups in.
It's excellent. It really is.
Getting too much flashback there. Oh, there we go. That's a bit better.
It's a lovely PRS and one with an unfinished neck on it. Well, slightly sort of finished on it, but it's not the sort of the glossy neck that you kind of have on the back of some PRSs.
It's hard to get the lighting's a bit wacky on that extra camera.
Yeah.
Okay, cool, man, yeah, amazing.
This is a great
single coil. Is that the precursor to the John Mayer?
The Silver Sky?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It could be.
I honestly thought he commissioned that guitar and said, PRS, I want you to make a guitar that looks like a Strat for me.
I reckon if you, it's just that guitar with a different pickguard.
Yeah, possibly.
It's got the Strat pickguard on it.
Possibly.
Man.
Don't tell John Mayer that. I think he thinks it was just for him.
Oh, man. Well, let's have a look who has joined us around the traps. We're still on Facebook. Good afternoon, folks. Who's on Facebook? We've got Jimmy Vivino, Glenn Daly.
Oh, all right.
Is the amp on 11? Yes, one louder.
One louder.
Is Glenn Daly a buddy of yours?
He is, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
Live with Josh Smith. Maybe, have I?
He's the drummer in the covers band that I sometimes play with.
We've got some people watching on YouTube. Not sure where am I. Oh, hang on. Chats. Turn on. Right. Hold potentially inappropriate messages for review. Does that mean from us or from...
Hopefully both.
Yeah. Don't worry. Anything you write will never match our inappropriate messages to young people. Turn on. Hello, folks on YouTube and hello, Twitch. Alan, we're going to do 52 NC Red Walrus. Oh, hello, wherever you are in the world, sir.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Is that Nigel?
No, Nigel comes on as Nigel.
Nigel. There's only one Nigel.
He doesn't cloak himself, so. What should we do first?
Do you want to do smooth?
Yeah, we can do smooth. We're going to play along. We're going to play along to a little smooth backing track. I'm going to have a crack at this solo. If I get it wrong, I'll just do it again.
No, you won't.
No?
Just get it right.
All right.
Just for a change.
All right. That's hard to do. This is not fair on me. All right, well, we're going to try smooth, and I'm just going to make up my own solo. And, let's give it a go. Did you know that, there's this young guy, Marcus, Jerry will know. Who's that young blues guy coming to the country? Marcus Wells, is it? Marcus Wells? You seen this kid? It's unbelievable, man. It's unbelievable.
You getting him on the show?
I've sent him a message. Okay. Yeah, I would like him to come on. So, but anyway, we're gonna kick in with solo number 2. It's somewhere around here. Oh, I think it's
very well prepared as usual, viewers.
Very well prepared.
Very nice.
I like that. Short and sweet. Short and sweet.
I think you got all the notes there.
I got all the notes, Alan.
In the right order.
Do you think so? Yeah, I'm on a PRS Custom 22.
That one is a nice one.
That is a nice guitar. And I have everything. I have the lights on all my pedals. I've got a compressor. I've got a tube screamer. I've got a Blues Mood by Moore.
So you put the compressor on even with the distortion?
Yeah, sometimes I do. I just kind of like that it's a bit of a boost and a bit of a flat sound.
Okay.
Whereas some people like when Josh Smith was here, he hates compressors.
Yeah. It ruins his dynamics.
Yeah, or maybe I ruined his dynamics. I don't know. I think he hated me, but that's okay. I'm down with that. And I have a wah-wah as well, so I can give him... That's all I'm going to do. Yeah. I like that.
But yeah, it sounds good. Really good. Lovely guitar.
Man. Well, what do you think of this beer? It's delicious.
I don't mind that one. I'm not sure about the top, but...
Yeah, I feel like...
I don't know what that was all about, but...
It's like a baby beer or something. A beer for babies. Do you think... Have you got any babies? Do you have children?
Not that I know of, no.
Oh, okay. I wonder if you're going to give them beer to drink.
I would, definitely. Is that not allowed anymore?
No.
I mean, that's what I got fed when I was a kid.
How old were you?
Little nip of whiskey when I was screaming my head off.
That's what they used to do. That's what my... someone told me this, it's like baby who can't sleep well. You get their dummy and you dip it in some Scotch whiskey.
Straight in there.
They're out, you know. Yeah. 20 hours later.
For the raging.
And then, like, 2 weeks later, they're addicted. How old were you when you started drinking, Ellen? Times were different back then.
That's a loaded question.
We can understand. Man. I won't cast a judgment.
I think I probably
I promise I won't say anything.
Into a pub for the first time when I was 17.
Oh, right. Probably. That's quite sensible.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Because even though I was quite tall.
Yes.
I hung around with a lot of people, that some of which looked like they were still 11 years old.
Right.
So that was
lady boys.
That was usually the problem getting into the pub. What about you?
I was out being naughty. I think I was 14.
Really?
In Brisbane, I was going up to no good. Yeah, because there's nothing else to do up there. There is now. I mean, there's more people there, but. I don't encourage that behavior, by the way. I think it was just a different time, you know.
Oh, yeah.
The early 2000s.
Well, I saw a photo of you the other day, back from 1995, which was, I didn't recognize
you. I used to have some hair.
Yeah,
a lot of hair. Yes, I did, and I couldn't quite, it was out of control. I was a bit out of control back then.
Were you?
Yeah, I was involved. You see this green screen here? There was a lot of that going on in my life. It was a constant green haze everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, now Jared Orman is watching, and he is the man who brought Josh Smith in.
Right.
And he may be able to tell me who this young blues kitty is that's coming in. Mark is somebody or other. If you know the answer, we've already had our quiz this morning. We were giving away a Sanchez guitar, a Dirty Sanchez.
Right. Mm. And who won?
We don't know yet. We have to go through it, and it's a tricky one.
Okay.
Because we put questions forward that could have a multitude of answers, and so we select the best answers and we go from there. Otherwise, everyone would just be Googling, you know.
Okay.
So and so played on.
So there's a bit. There's obviously a bit of favoritism in this, but I don't.
Yeah. Is it? Well, yeah. Look, it's not rigged. I mean, Michael Ray's not going to win. But, it's not rigged. Mark Teague is on. Mark Teague bought something for us, and I do have the tracking details for it somewhere, but it's on its way, and it wasn't
to somewhere.
It's going somewhere. You're in Tasmania. I hope so. It's not whiskey, and it's not a chicken. So there we go.
Could be one and the other, couldn't it?
Yes. Santana. One of my all-time favorites. The Colonel nails us off.
Did he put an exclamation mark there? Yeah, because I was surprised as well. Mark, that he actually nailed the solo.
That's what I've been practicing all day. Alan, speaking of solos, should we have a look at Black
Magic I think wand. So, yeah.
Are we just going to jam it out a bit?
Yeah, yeah.
Have a bit of
yeah.
fun? Okay. Cool, folks. We are going to jam along to Black Magic Woman.
We might get pulled off.
And, yeah, we may get taken from the air.
Yeah.
We don't want that to happen, but we're going to go for it. And we'll see. Hopefully they won't take us off for a jam track.
Yeah.
But look, we'll be on Twitch. If we disappear, you can find us on twitch.tv/guitarkernel. Maybe I should write that in. Should I write that in? No.
Nah.
Do it okay, later. Let's do it.
Let's play.
Folks, it's Black Magic Woman.
Ooh, I like that.
This allows me to have a little drink while you sort of work. And loud when we tested this. It's the beer.
Could be.
That's on.
Could be that.
Alan, just play anything you want. Let me check the Alan Leslie level here. Oh, that was a little.
Could be the amp.
A little bit more. Let me turn up the master a touch.
All right. That I
give
can
me
do.
Your master. Alright,
a bit more.
Let's check it out. Hang on, this is mine. Yeah, I'm in the red.
Better?
That's better. That's better. I reckon you could even go a bit louder.
Why not?
One more, one louder, Alan. One louder.
A little bit louder.
Let's go louder. You can always knock it back on the volume of your guitar. You can knock it back.
Better? Yeah, I think that's alright.
Is it okay? You like that? Yeah, I just couldn't hear it before.
Yeah. loading off there.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Alan Leslie with Black Magic Woman. Do you like that? I could do late night radio. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Alan Leslie. He's been arrested again for... Now, Alan, should we move on to the next exciting bit? Let's see if we're still on television somewhere. Right, we still... How about that? I like that.
Ooh, so this one could make you vomit.
Okay. Sour beer. Watermelon smash.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. You know, someone brought one of these stomping grounds in, and I had it, and it was so strong. It's like I dropped some acid or something. Wait a second. No, I had dropped acid.
Yeah. That's what it was.
I totally forgot.
Refreshingly tart. That's what this is.
Well, I love a refreshing tart.
I'll just line them up for you.
Just keep throwing those dollies in, buddy. It says, packed with real watermelon. Okay. This goss is suitably salty. Subtly salty.
Goss?
G-O-S-E? What is that?
I've never heard of that word.
I'm not up to speed with that. Bright with fruity aromas and refreshingly tart, like a smashing fruit punch. Okay.
Let's go.
Here we go. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, man. It's stuck. Hang on. Watch out.
Wow! Oh, it's a gusher! Yeah.
Yeah, I've got fucking watermelon all over me.
I wonder if it's because I
shook it. Lucky we're allowed to swear.
I wonder if it's because I shook it before I gave it to you.
Alan, you wouldn't do anything that cheeky.
I would. It's a gusher, though.
Oh, man.
You should be used to that anyway.
It's always a gusher with me.
I was referring to your ceiling.
It's always a gusher. It's usually about... my gushers are about this sort of 355 minutes. Man, I don't know about that straight away. Even the smell of it's kind of sickening.
You know what? It's not bad, though.
You reckon?
It's weird. Oh my God. Really weird.
That is. Well, actually, yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to go with that now. It's kicking in.
Yeah.
What's the percentage of it? You got to watch these. Oh, that's 4.2. The one he brought in was like 6.7 or something in a can. Ridiculous.
So, yeah, with your gushing, I was referring to your little leak that you had.
Oh.
I don't mean just because you're getting old. I mean the one that you had in your roof.
Yeah. I shouldn't laugh, but speaking of getting old, I was in Melbourne Central, and I saw an older gentleman, and he was coming up the escalator, and I thought there was something wrong with him, and so I moved away. And he got to the top of the escalator, and he just passed out and pee-peed his pants everywhere all over the floor, and I sort of stepped over him, and people were screaming, and I thought, God damn it. Old people! My goodness. Anyway.
I left him.
Like, I'm from the city. You know. Get out of my way, wee-weeing old person. I have a place to go. Very quickly. Now,
zero sympathy here, zero folks. Sympathy. No, nothing at all.
No. We're in South Melbourne. We don't care. Yesterday there was some rain. There was a little bit of rain,
wasn't it?
Yeah. And it was absolutely pouring down the wall inside the building.
Yeah. Mm.
So I had to run around with blankets and...
No damage?
Covered up. Yeah, well, the carpet's all ruined. So, I got to get a new carpet.
I mean... To be fair,
it was ruined.
I think it's actually an improvement.
I think senior sales executive Panda had what I call an Alan Leslie morning over there. And she had, I'm not even making this up. Last weekend, Nigel and I go live, and the dog just rolls over, never comes in. In the corner, and then just strolls out again to serve customers. I thought, that's very Alan Leslie.
Oh, it's brilliant.
Dear me, how's your job going?
Oh, awesome.
Did you get a promotion?
I did, recently, yeah, I did. Yeah, I did.
What are you now?
That's the thing, I'm still doing the same thing, so, yeah.
What's your title? Do you, are you like Nigel and you get like, you know, he just calls himself Chief Inventor and he's got it on a card and everything.
Has he? Yeah. Has he got a card?
He's got a card. Got Chief Inventor. You don't have a card?
No. No. I can deny everything in that case.
It's I have a card. I have Colonel. Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah. It's just a blank card with the words Colonel on one side. That's really it. That's it.
Yeah.
Everybody
knows. When you're getting a Chief Inventor, I mean, that is a pretty cool title.
It's pretty amazing. I had some people call up this week and it's like, you know that guy you have on the show who's on Current Affairs?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Christina said that he was on there, but just flashed up briefly before
we have
just putting him into the back of the van, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They chased him down the alley and wrapped him over the head with a camera stand in the back of the van. We have exclusive rights to him. And so, yeah, I set him up. I called up and I said, this is Colonel Smith. There's a man called Nigel, and he's a crook, and here's where he lives. Go get him. And they did.
And they
found
did.
Him. Yeah. Chased him down the back alley. Oh, God, Lord.
Right. Shall we do the next one before we probably get kicked off air?
Yeah, yeah. Well, let's see who's with us. Thank you, Mark Teague, for that lovely Santana. Yes, love the tracking. Cool. Yeah, excellent work. Thanks. Thanks, Michael Ray. Lovely. Is anyone on YouTube? Hello, YouTubers. No. No. Well, okay. I don't.
3 million care. Viewers.
We've got 3 million. We've got, yeah. There, you want to see Thunderstruck on Twitch?
Thunderstruck? Where?
Do you know the Thunderstruck? Oh. What's the one chord that they play? Is it an E?
Oh. B? That's about... I can't... If I had a practice, that would be...
Yeah.
I think he picked it. He picks it as well.
Does he?
Yeah, he does, yeah.
You've got to use your first and your third, I reckon.
He's a ferocious picker.
He's crazy. So. Do you use your first and your third or your first and your pinky?
Pinky.
Wow.
I just can't do it. I'm not picking everything, so right. I'm cheating. There you go. There's Thunderstruck for
it's
you.
It's a great track. You know, I was living in Canada when that came out, and that was killer. It was a huge hit. Was huge. There's a Celine Dion version of that as well.
Oh yeah, I've seen that. It was good as well. So,
amazing. Yeah, your eyes didn't burn out of your head. No, she's. I love Celine Dion. I think she's great. Yeah,
you do.
Yeah, but you know,
you'd love it even more if you had her head on a spike. So
right up on the green screen.
Where you're going there?
I think I have a green screen wallpaper of that.
You do.
I tell you what's interesting though is if you speak to French people. Because she's French-Canadian, but if you talk to people from the real France, like the country, they have a comedian who imitates her, and she's really popular, and so they all try and imitate her accent and whatever. Anyway, enough of that. Should we do a little jam?
I think so.
And we'll come back and rate these beers.
I had a fun fact on Santana before we...
Give me the Santana.
So he didn't start playing the guitar. So there's a question for the viewers. What instrument... did Santana first start playing?
Ladies and gentlemen.
And don't Google it, Michael Ray.
Michael Ray! Get off that computer! I don't know if he even needs a computer. He's so good.
It's just all in his brain.
It's amazing. It's incredible. Hey, Michael Ray, have you ever been on Rock Quiz? Have you been on Rock Quiz before?
Don't know. Yeah, he's banned.
He's banned from Rock Quiz.
He's banned.
He was too good. Yeah, he won everything.
Too good.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
There you go. What's your fact? What do we got?
He started off on the violin.
Wow.
Started off playing the violin.
Did anyone know that?
And then he went to play guitar.
Wow.
So,
have you ever heard his funny Woodstock story?
No.
Well, he went to Woodstock, and I almost went to Woodstock. We've discussed this before. And right before he was due to go on, they gave him some acid. Right, and he'd never had acid before.
Yeah. And so he claimed.
So he we're on acid right now. And anyway, and when you look at that video where they're playing the, whatever they're playing, okay, Samba,
yeah.
Well, I can't remember the one. Oh, soul sacrifice. Soul sacrifice. And he kind of has this crazy expression in his
and that was the acid.
He's struggling to hold the guitar, and he says, the guitar was like it. This is a, sorry, Spanish people, but I gotta do it. The guitar was like a snake, and I was trying to tame the evil snake. And I'm like, man, that's, you're an old tripper. Yeah.
I didn't realize he was French.
Yes. The guitar was le guitar. Un snack.
So he was having a bit of trouble. It still sounded good, though.
Still sounded awesome.
Now that, I suppose
on
that's
the SG,
part of what really propelled him into superstardom, isn't it? All the
That was the Woodstock thing. I'm so unhappy with the watermelon.
You don't like it?
No.
It's grown on me. It really is.
So. I'm just going back, and I'm just like, BentSpoke, I love you.
Didn't you say you had one of these?
I've got one in the fridge. Yeah, I haven't opened it yet.
It takes a certain day, I think.
Do you want to see something cool, man?
Go on.
This is what my student, the judge, brought me for Christmas. You ready? Hang on. I almost need two hands. God! To pick this bad boy up. Check it out.
Oh, what is it? Oh, my God.
Shall we? When the Colonel drinks wine... He likes Cote de Rhone in large quantities.
Very nice.
How about that?
That's very kind of him to do that.
I know. He's a judge.
Wow.
And he is judged, in this case, very fairly. Alan, should
not,
we...
Do you not feel... does it not scare you a little bit? Teaching a judge?
Oh, I thought you meant the size of that bottle.
The size of that bottle.
It does scare me a little bit. Teaching a judge, well, I don't want to make any... I don't want to make too many mistakes, so, you know. It's, you don't want to make a mistake.
Yeah.
You don't want to make a mistake with a judge because...
He'll remember.
Yeah.
He'll remember.
He'll remember when I'm in front of him. You know. Remember that time? Shut up. For the term of your natural life.
You lied to me. You said that riff went like this.
Yeah.
And I looked it up online and it goes like that instead.
The rock court. Yeah. You said... I'm teaching him... Sweet Bone Up My Grandma. I mean, Sweet Home Alabama. And he loves it.
He loves
we're
it.
We're doing that, yeah. We're right. doing, what's the other one?
Trying to be good.
Does it.
Do that one.
That would be great. We got to do some 50 stuff. I got to do it better than that. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to do some more Santana to celebrate our Christmas. We are also recording this, and, so we'll be up later.
Watch this.
Oh.
Just because.
Oh, yeah. Alan's got a magic trick. Okay, now.
Ready?
We are going to make Alan's head disappear live on camera. Here we go. Oh, we have to see it real time because we're on delay. I have to put the real time on. Alan, come back! Where have you gone?
Where's my head
what
gone?
Sort of black magic is this?
How does it look like? With, oh yeah, that looks even worse,
wow,
doesn't
that's
it?
Wacky.
That's probably. I think I'm going to wear it for the rest of the
if
show.
If you're a guest on the show, my advice is don't wear. Don't wear green to
do
the show.
Do not wear green.
Should we leave it on and play?
I think yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I'm gonna be snipping this jam session out.
Why?
Well, because I have a thing called jam sessions.
Oh.
And right. I do it. You and sure you want to have no head for
you? Yeah.
Are you sure?
Shit, yeah.
All right, we're doing...
I think this is going to get about 3 million views on YouTube, so...
It's got sparkly things going on. It's white. I can see, if you dip your head, I can see a lovely bottle of scotch.
Lots of people over the years have said I've got a bit of
Jameson's.
An empty head. So there you go.
They were right.
They were right.
There we go. Alan,
so which
should
one
we rate these beers?
Yeah, I think
Let's
so.
Let's rate them. Okay. Let's have a look. BentSpoke Brewing Company, Crankshaft.
Mm.
Born and brewed in Canberra. What do you give this?
3.5 for that, I think.
I would have gone more if they hadn't put that stupid top end. I don't like that at all.
Trying to be hipster.
It's just ridiculous. Yeah. And okay, come on, man. What are you giving this?
A 2 for that.
Oh man, yeah. I'm gonna give this a 1.
Oh,
sorry. Yeah. Oh, stomping ground. You fucked up. I'm sorry. No swearing on the show, but well, yeah. Anyway, but that's disgusting.
You don't like it.
That is disgusting.
You're still gonna drink it though.
I'm still gonna drink it because I've got nothing else. So.
Well, you do. You got this giant bottle of wine here.
Oh my god.
No, no good.
I did, in Stomping Ground's credit, I did have a beer yesterday from Stomping Ground, and it was delicious. Yeah,
it is pretty.
So they make a good beer, but that is shocking. So I think that's the first one I've ever given on the show.
You reckon? You've not liked. You generally don't like the fruity sort of.
I don't like fruit in beer. No. I mean,
it doesn't go usually, does it? It's but you got to try these things.
No, yeah.
You have to try these.
Sorry things. For swearing, children. I know there's a lot of children that watch the Drink Beer Show late at night. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna go out with a bit of a jam. We're gonna go. Oh ye come over.
I thought you were going to say, "Oh, come all ye faithful," or something like that.
We could jam over that as well. I mean, what are you doing for Christmas, Alan?
Oh, it's going to be a pretty quiet one.
Right.
Because I had the holiday a little while ago in Japan. So in Japan. I think I'll be working.
You're just hanging local? Yeah. Maybe we could do a 2019 January special edition for the shop even opens.
Yes, if you want.
Well, we'll come back and say hello. We'll have a bit of a jam. This is Oi Come Over.
We'll get stuck into the wine.
We're gonna, yeah, we might do that. We'll that could be the whole show. Sit for 8 hours while Alan and I polish off. God knows.
And get worse and worse.
Maybe we could set up a little rotisserie and do a suckling pig and have, like, it'd be so enjoyable to watch. Ladies and gentlemen, let's do it. Do you want to go first?
Yeah.
Okay, cool, I like that.
It's an A, is it? Isn't
it's oh, you know what I've done? I've turned this down. It's A Dorian. Play a track. got you again.
That was good. That was very Santana-esque. That was lovely.
I channeled my inner.
Was it the acid that you had just before the show?
Definitely the acid.
Finally kicked in.
The BRS was like a demon snake, and I could not control it. So Alan,
Very nice.
Got you with a knife. Alan, thank you for joining me again. It's been a wonderful.
My pleasure.
And we had your head disappearing.
Is it still gone?
Still gone? Is it? Oh, we're still on.
It's
How about
still
that?
Gone.
My goodness.
Look at that.
My goodness.
Yeah, I think I've never looked better.
Well, it takes the sort of the need for a wig or a hat away.
Yeah.
Or anything else, you know.
Yeah.
All you need is like a clear see-through vision with some sparkles, and it really makes it. Well, thank you for coming in, Alan. I know
Thanks
you're a busy man and all sorts of stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it for 2019 for the Drink Beer Play Guitar show.
But we'll be back with more beer.
More beer.
And more guitars.
And more guitars.
Next year.
Next year, we will. We'll definitely be back. Thanks for watching. Should we say hello? We've got a few new comments. Oh my goodness. Jason Lee Arcos joined. He's a fan.
Nothing
player.
Inside. Yeah, I know.
John Collier. Yep, tracking sounds good. Righto. Green shirts next week. Oh my goodness.
That's a
we
good
should
idea.
Just do a show where That's we're all in green idea. And so all you can see is the guitar.
Oh, look, if we're going to do that, we might as well just go naked next time.
Like, why don't we...
Just the guitars to cover our modesties.
No, well, how about this? How about this week we go Freddie Mercury style, a full green suit with the with the genital parts cut away.
Right.
So all you see is our genitals and a guitar.
You've been thinking about this a little bit too much.
I've been planning this for a long time. How do you think that would go down?
I think that would definitely get a few more viewers.
We'd be pulled off on air for that, let me tell you. Great shirts next week.
Great.
Nothing inside. Peter Langford, nothing inside.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I think he's talking about my head.
Right, yes.
I couldn't agree more.
Michael Ray, yes I was. I got a wild card from Brian Nankervis. Oh, for one of their live shows. He was on Rock Quiz.
Oh, there you go.
Did you win it?
You must have.
You must have. It's like the best. Oh, we're getting a bit choppy in the stream. If you don't want to see...